Yeah, what's up, everybody? It's your boy, London VK a la carte. And we're doing a reaction. I'm switching it up again.
We're doing a reaction to CJ Champion.
I believe that's right.
So then he throws a punch where bro ends up stopping
his punch. CJ with DJ lunch. Champ. If you don't know who he is, he's an anime lover. Such as me. I mean, I used to love anime. I still like anime. I don't love it like I used to, where I used to be hooked on that shit. But I still watch it here and there. I still gotta finish season 2 of Promise to Neverland. If you haven't checked that show out, check it. Season 1 was good. Even season 2 is better. But he does reactions to a lot of the animes, and he finds clips of or evidence of who's the most savagest persons and stuff that goes crazy, who's disrespectful, and who got like kills. Like, he has different videos of different people. And Nezuko, you know, if you don't know me, I love me some Nezuko. So when I get a chance to see her beat the shit out of somebody, oh yeah, I love that. And he got that in this video. There's a couple of his videos I like. I might start doing some reactions that would. There's this one. There's the truck coon. Let me know y'all thoughts in the comments below if y'all want me to do one. Y'all want me to do another one. Let's get it.
Box. And straight up just cheap shots. So then he throws a punch where bro ends up stopping his punch with a lunchbox. And straight up just cheap shots.
But everybody like, hey, my boy, you shouldn't have done that. And yeah, man, I ain't even gonna lie. He should have not done that.
So then, bro just started blasting. Jesus Christ!
Boy, a menace, basically. It's different protagonists being menaces, basically. Menace to society. And who should join his round table of black Air Force Ones. He has a lot of them. I feel like, I gotta put in the comments, Dracula, I feel like Dracula is one of them too. Because in the Castlevania, oh man, Dracula, he a menace. He's a damn menace. I like his intro.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, it is finally
gobble,
time
gobble,
to return to a series that we have not been to in, Jesus Christ, 4 goddamn months. I know some of y'all niggas probably like, he forgot about that shit, didn't he? Well, for your information, yeah, I ain't even gonna lie y'all, my boy, I forgot about that shit. Hey, but listen, it's finally time to return to the most disrespectful moments in anime history. The series that we will observe some of the most outlandish, outrageous, most brutal beatdowns in anime history. And just some moments that just make you look at the screen like, well, damn, did they really have to do the nigga like that?
I feel like Android 18 and 19, they menaces too.
Grab some popcorn. As I tell you about our sponsor today, Monster
Legends. Monster Legends.
Gentlemen, first up to the plate is actually a moment that came out pretty recently, and that is Nezuko stomping out Daki. Now, as we can see, Tanjiro's fighting Daki right now, and he's about to cut the bitch head off. But bro ended up choking because the nigga forgot to breathe. So while he's doing his greatest General Grievous impression, trying to get his breath back, Nezuko comes from behind and kicks the shit out the bitch. God damn! Made the whole world like a bowling ball. And look at her, she angry as hell, biting the hell out of that damn bamboo retainer, whatever the hell that is, with all that damn slobber coming out of damn mouth. Like, bro, she kicked half of her head off. So they start boxing, but Doc gives her the chop and just slings her like 3 houses down.
That fight scene was crazy.
And she is still angry as shit. So while Daki's monologuing and talking shit, Nezuko gets up from that and regrows literally all of her limbs. So then she takes a whole bite out of the damn bamboo stick. And Jesus Christ, look at this absolute menace. Nigga, she got veins in her forehead. And look at Daki, she like, what the
What type of crack did this just snort? So then Nezuko blitzes her ass. Oh my god! Straight up stepped on her ass. Made the sound like a door creaking open. Nigga, her whole foot is in her back. And look at her staring at her like shit. I know your back ain't been blown out like this before, has it? So then she lifts up her foot and straight up breaks her arm in half. And dog, she is smiling. She is smiling. Yo, she is a menace. She is kicking the living shit out of this. Stepping on her ass harder than a thong. My god, bro, her head is bouncing off the ground. But then Daki loses, so she just slices up her entire body. But bro, her blood is literally holding her together right now. And then she just started burning her ass. So then she reattaches her head, jumps up to high heaven, and just plants her face into the ground. So then she just starts stomping her out again, ass tooted up and everything. And bro, at this point, this fight is over. Just let the bitch quit. Nezuko was like, nah, nigga, I ain't done yet. So then she gets her out, lines her up for the kick, and just straight up boots the bitch. But nah, we didn't think he'd get even worse for Daki, right? Well, it did. So while Tanjiro's trying to calm Nezuko down, Daki's trying to get back up and trying to land a hit on her. Tengen comes in and stops the whole attack. So while he's talking to Tanjiro, Daki's like, ooh, Hashira, you came to fight, nigga? And he like, shut your ass up. I ain't got time for your weak ass. So then she starts talking, and then her whole head just falls off. In just a split of a second, this man stopped her whole attack and straight up decapitated the bitch. So while she's complaining about why she's an upper six, and Tengen like, so why is your literal head in your fucking hands right now, you sorry ass bitch? And then she started crying. Hey, yo, this girl was talking all this like 10 minutes ago, and now she's crying her ass off. Hey, but you know what? Watching this ass whooping taught us all a lesson.
Never
judge a book by its cover. Because that one quiet nigga in the class could have some hands and some black forces in his backpack. Alright, next up on the list today is one of the most classic beatdowns of all time, and that is the Tenjo Tenge Lunchroom Agni Kai. So while Masataka and Bob are having lunch, Nagi comes in and he wants to smoke, and he's trying to run the hands with Masataka, and keep in mind, bruh, Nagi's only been at this school for 2 days, and he already trying to run somebody's fade on the second day of school. So he throws a punch, but bro stops it with a chopstick. Then he gut checks homie and sends him flying. So everybody clears out the lunchroom because they're about to throw down. They're about to have a straight Agni Kai. So Takayanagi's ready to humble his ass. He like, bro, it's only your second day and you're already starting shit. So then he says, all right, bro, since you were first here, I'll give you a handicap. All you gotta do is land one hit. So Nagi runs in and gets kicked in the temple. And then bro just started blasting on some Chun-Li type shit. Nigga hitting him with the helicopter kick. And just straight up teeing off on bro when he hasn't even thrown a punch yet. Look at Bob, bro. He like, damn. My nigga getting his ass whipped. So then somehow Soichiro gets up from that shit. So bro comes in flying with another kick. But then bro ducks under it on some Steve Fox type shit. And he throws a punch, but he grabs the punch midair and hits a whole spinning move on that nigga. And bro is out cold. It's over. But then no girl wakes him up and she's like, nigga, you really gonna get your ass whooped in front of all these niggas? You sorry as hell with that fake ass Super Saiyan cut you got going on, my boy. So Takayanagi is pissed off right now. This man is ready to beat this nigga to a pulp. Nigga, like, this is the first day I want him to whoop a nigga's ass so bad. So then he throws a punch where bro ends up stopping his punch with a lunchbox and straight up just cheap shots him. But everybody like, hey, my boy, you shouldn't have done that shit. And yeah, my nigga, I ain't even gonna lie. He should have not done that shit. So then bro just started blasting. Jesus Christ. Boy hit that nigga with an HR-64 bomb. And they trying to get him off, but he like, got the way, nigga. Yo, dog literally dug his own grave. So then he picks up his lifeless body and gut checks. Oh my God, bro. That nigga's breakfast is gone. Just look at this, bro didn't awaken the demon. So then he throws a kill shot and it's over. The screen just cuts to black. That nigga's dead. So later on, we cut to him sitting on top of this roof and looking at him, he like, damn, I really got my ass whooped on the second day of school. And the thing is, he picked the fight and it was in front of his girl too. Hey, yo, bro. Nah, bro, that's it. That's disrespectful as shit.
Yeah, menace.
Alright, next up on the list is Adam smoking Ricky's pack. So Ricky challenges Adam, who is basically a love child between Dio and Hisoka, and the kid looked up to Tony Hawk. And this man does one of the most absolutely disrespectful things you could ever do to anybody. So the race starts, so Ricky takes off, but Adam is still standing there. And then this nigga pulls out a whole pack of Black and Miles and starts smoking that shit. Ain't no fucking way, dog. And this nigga just straight monologues for about 2 minutes, talking about how good his Black and Miles are. So after he's done with his smoke break, he picks up his board and just starts Naruto running. Nigga went from 0 to 60 in a second, and he is gone. And within 5 seconds, he's already on his ass. He like, what up, little nigga? I hope you like that 2 minute head start I gave your ass. And this nigga still got the Black and Mild in his hand, bruh. Onto him and just starts dancing on the skateboard. Like, nigga, what the f*** is happening right now? Then he pushes him down and just holds him an inch away from the ground. And look at him, he like, don't close your eyes, little nigga. You should savor this shit. So then Ricky passes him and does a nice-ass little grind. So Adam like, okay, I'll f*** with you, my boy. So he throws down the cigarette and hits this nasty-ass Casper's like, god damn, my boy. Then this nigga does this pose and hits this called the love hug, and he is skating uphill. This nigga said, f*** the laws of physics, my boy. So then Ricky just went flying. Bro just ended up rolling down the whole hill about like 50 yards. Like, Jesus Christ, back on skate 3, that is a fat ass going haul of meat. Hey, but nah, this man wasn't even done yet, bro. Because while I'm talking about this anime, I gotta add one more thing that he did. So they're having this tournament, and Adam is racing Cherry right now. And Cherry is actually beating him right now, because I ain't even gonna lie, bro. His board is like actual cheats. So then Adam pulls in front of him, and then this nigga just starts tap dancing on his damn board. So then Cherry says, don't get too cocky, nigga. But Adam's like, nah, don't be too optimistic, motherfucker. So then he gets off his board, runs up at him, and slaps the nigga with the board. But said, get out of my face with that cheating ass board, nigga. Hit his ass so hard to replay 3 different times. And then while he's on the ground, he starts talking shit to him, and he says, yeah, the reason I never responded to your beefs is because, yeah, nigga, you born as shit. Bro, pack it up, bro. This man is a menace. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to our final moment. So I decided I might as well save this one for last. Gotta make it quick though before these niggas get on my ass. And that is Mihawk pulling a butter knife on Zoro. So we all know Zoro's dream. He wants to be the greatest swordsman of all time. But to do that, he's gonna have to get past this nigga. I mean, look how bro pulled up looking like a dripped out vampire slayer. And look at him, how pitiful. Weak one. Nigga, you weak as hell and you sorry as hell, but you know what? I'll give you a handicap. I'll pull out a fucking butter knife. And look at dude, I'm no beast that goes all out when hunting a rabbit. So unfortunately, this is the smallest shit I got. Yo, pack it up, my nigga. Like, dog, back in the day during East Blue, this was the craziest shit. This man got 3 stores and it got stopped by a butter knife. Zoro's like, what the f-? Oh, nigga, I'm out of my league. And just look at him, prairie all fucking day. So then Zoro jumps up, but then he just gets snapped. Man stabbed him with a butter knife and it sent through shockwaves. So then he like, state your name, nigga. Rep your set. As courtesy of surviving so long, I'll actually pull out my real sword. So then we have our stereotypical anime sword clash. Yeah, bro. We knew Zoro was taking that L. Even with Durag, bro. Hey, but even though this is disrespectful as it made our boy who he is today. Cause this man no doubt a menace. So yeah, that was the most disrespectful moments in anime history 3. And I mean, hell, since we bringing it back, I might as well just do one of these once every month with all the other videos. So we'll try to make this series a little consistent. But anyways, make sure y'all go subscribe to the second channel. We almost had 100K on that bitch. And also follow your boys IG and Twitter. And also make sure to go check out Monster Legends. The link is in the description below. And thank you guys for sponsoring this video today. But anyways, y'all take it easy. And I'm out as hell.
All right, make sure y'all go follow his sub to his channel. Make sure you go sub to my channel. Make sure y'all bite that like button, bite that subscribe button, and join the Vampire Academy, because all we are is in a feeding frenzy. Take care. Let me know down in the comments below if y'all want me to do some more of these. He's out of here. Peace.